Well, hi, everybody, and welcome back to part two of our exploration of OBI, or Oracle Business Intelligence. We discussed opening a report in section one. Now we're going to go back and pick up where we left off and modify a report. In our first episode, we discussed filters. Filters determine the information that is displayed in a report. If you are interested in looking at different information, for example, from a different account or department, you can change the filter that is being used for a particular report. The filter settings are located in the Edit Prompt section of the report. Now, to access these prompts in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, find the heading labeled Edit Prompts. Beside that label is a plus sign. Select the plus sign to reveal the existing drop-down boxes. Initially, the department prompt is set to the President's Office. Well, unless you happen to be in the President's Office, step one is to select your department. For this demonstration, we've chosen to use the Provost Office. There are a number of ways you can change a prompt to modify a filter. The fastest method is to use the Search feature. To get to the Search feature, choose the department drop-down. At the very bottom of the drop-down box is the more/search link. Select the link to open the Select Values dialog box. To search for the Provost's Office, change the name drop-down from Stats to Contains, uncheck Match Case, and type either the department number or the word Provost. Then click Search, and if everything's going well, the Provost Office should be listed. To add the Provost Office to the filter, double-click that item in the left column, and it will move to the right column. To remove the President's Office from the filter, double-click that item in the right column, and it moves to the left. Select OK in the lower right portion of the Edit Prompt windows, and select Apply. In a moment, a new table will appear in the lower part of the screen. Now, to give yourself more screen space, minimize the Edit Prompts window by clicking the minus sign next to the heading. And to verify your changes, note the report filters below the report table. That filter should indicate the department is set to Provost. You can further refine your report table by moving and removing columns. For example, let's assume the project and class fields are not going to be used. We can remove them for a cleaner view by right-clicking on the column heading and choosing Exclude Column. You can remove as many columns as you like. Make sure one column disappears before you attempt to remove another one. You can also move columns by selecting the small gray handlebar that appears at the very top of the column when you hover over it. When you move your cursor over the handlebar, a four-way arrow will appear. Click and drag to move that column to the desired position. Your customized view can be saved and even reused. Come on back in part three and we will cover how to save your customizations.